if they call him, tell them, oh man, this is evil. Stay there, tell them, come back, let me recap all that. This is a reality, folks. These are live phones. We're not screening these calls. If somebody calls in and says their hospital is full, let them on. They don't call. This is not going on. The America that we've known and loved, the America that was the land of freedom, the land of dying, and everything our enemies are doing is about domesticating us, killing us down and making us dependent on them. The food shortages that we've got, the depression is going to be long and very, very serious. In fact, it's probably too late now to even talk.
people want to talk about helping the poor Africans. This guy's actually been there. He pulled me to the side and told me this intel. And the things I've seen, the things I know, which shocked most people. And I'm sure there's a lot of other callers that have similar stories and similar intel. One day, all this information will come out. And this is the start of the New World Order. This is the 666 mark of the beast. Better pray up, people. You better be prepared, because I'm telling you, do not take anything from Gates. Don't take his shots. Don't take his poisons. If you take that mark, your soul will go to hell. Look at that.
Well, that's the scary part, is they're up front saying this may really hurt you. I mean, they're not even lying about hurting you now. They're saying, you want to leave your house or have a job, you take this. And by the way, it may hurt you. Sign this form waiving your rights. Boy, you know to grab both butt cheeks when they're doing that.
Now it's time to fall on your knees and pray to God, ask Him to forgive you what you've done, and to save your soul. And I'm not talking just showing up.
No, it's true. We've been evil. That's why this is happening.
Yes, we have killed millions of innocents in this nation, and God is punishing us for this.
And
this is what is doing it.
So that's exactly what it is. God bless you, brother.
No worry.
Oh, sorry, sir. I was talking over you. Go ahead. What you said? He's noticing somebody. And by the way, everything that guy's saying is all admitted. I mean, that's what's so crazy about this, is that they're counting every death for anybody that's had radical virus that shows up in your body. So that's what it's called, virus. And they're using it for total control. And by the way, there was a really bad pneumonia virus in the last 6 months. I haven't had a fever in 5 years. I got one. A lot of folks I know are really sick. It was back in November, December, January. And we said, hey, looks like it was already here. We had Steve Pacetic, high-level State Department CIA. He said, look, it's been here for 6 months. That was 4 months ago. Turns out that's all true. So they already knew this was here. They already know most of us have herd immunity. Most of us already have it. But see, when they test you for it now, it creates panic. That shuts down your businesses, which kills the economy, and that's what they're doing. So it's a real virus, folks. But if you've got vitamin D, vitamin C, and zinc, in about 3 to 5 times the level, you're incredible. But zinc at that level is toxic to your kidneys. So it's a give and take situation. I mean, the truth is, and I'm not a medical doctor, and I'm not going to advise me personally. When I've read, you take 10 times the normal level of zinc, it'll make your hair fall out, but you're not getting COVID-19 or any other cold virus. It's like the dog doesn't mind, but long term it'll eat the kittens. So let's go ahead and take a call here. Let's go ahead and talk to Brian in Pennsylvania, analyst at Health Insurance Company. Insurance companies in South Africa say that 29 times the death from the lockdown versus the virus. Brian, what do you know?
Yeah, I can take my call. I just wanted to hit a couple of different points, but the main point. Longevity and continuation of the business had been war game down. I have a couple of reasons why. I think that was probably the case.
Oh, it's all scripted, it's all choreographed worldwide. Yeah. From your own perspective, tell us.
Yeah, so beginning last year, around the holidays, so this is before even the news broke about what was happening in Wuhan, there's a big push for everyone basically at the ground level to make sure that they start booking their time off early next year, which I thought was strange. They had basically created a new branch of artificial intelligence, automated learning, with its own chains of management and reporting. Even more recently, and this is continuing, there was basically a war game to establish a plan of action should a lot of the Medicare, Medicaid, government services provider groups become insolvent, and what it creates a new plan, right? And that was being planned for about the second half of last year.
Brian, this is incredible. So you're saying you were seeing war games for industry collapse. You've never seen that before.
Exactly. They were wargaming for losing large amounts of provider groups in the small to medium sized range. It's becoming
so. They were wargaming for a vertical integration.
Essentially, yes. But they call it streamlining for efficiency. And part of that, I believe that, is predicting now that they're going to actually issue loans, interest-free loans, to the provider group. They're expecting 20% to 30% will default. So the CEO comes out with the new normal. This is new normal. All the middle upper management is parroting that.
Stay there. Come back, you're right. An artificially instituted global bankruptcy, vertical integration, Ryan, Pennsylvania, finish up. This is the